thank you, Lord. 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 Lord, you are great. You are wonderful. You are glorious. Glorious in holiness, fearful in praise. All these things wonder. Lord, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you glory.
Thank you, sir. Most high. Most
thank you. Yes.
Most righteous.
Yes.
Most wonderful. Blessing.
Yes.
We bless your name.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. What a privilege to be in the presence of God again today.
It is a good privilege. We want to welcome you. He's there to watch us. It's doing a lot for us. And we cannot but say thank you.
Hallelujah.
We want to appreciate God who gave us privilege.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. So we want to thank God for you, that you are there every time we are lost. The Lord will bless you. Thank you so much for what you are doing for us. Thank you for your contributions. Thank you for your life. Thank you. We appreciate you. Hallelujah. In the words of my wife, we value you.
Yes,
the Lord bless you. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You know, it's amazing. God is a great God.
Yes,
it's a great God. Look at it. Today is what? 4th of June. Can you see? I believe that this month will be better for you.
Amen.
It's a month of good news.
Yes.
All right. And I decree that good news
and
in your family,
receive it. Amen.
Good news in your family,
amen.
Good news in your job,
amen.
Good news in your career,
amen.
Good news,
amen.
Concerning your children,
amen.
Good news all around,
amen.
You, in the name of
amen.
Jesus. Receive good news,
amen.
This month in the name of
amen.
Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We celebrate you in the name of Jesus Christ. This is Relationship Tips with Pastor Akin and Yewale, live on Facebook. And as we always say, relationship is everything in life. That is our gospel.
That's right.
That's what we preach.
That's true.
And that's what we believe in.
Yes.
Glory to God. You're welcome, you're welcome, you're welcome, you're welcome today. Please don't forget to like our page at Pastor Akin. Like that page. Also on YouTube,
we have Akin and Yewale as a channel.
All right.
Please subscribe to that channel.
Glory.
The Lord bless you as you do that.
Amen.
We have a lot of videos uploaded already. This one too is going right there.
Yes, sir.
Yesterday we had 2 broadcasts yesterday. Everything is there.
Yes,
that will bless you and increase you, definitely. The Lord will bless you as you subscribe to Akin and Yewale
on YouTube. God bless you in the name of Jesus.
Thank
also,
you.
Don't forget.
God bless you.
Thank you for joining.
Thank you for joining.
Hallelujah to Jesus.
Amen.
Glory to God in heaven.
Hallelujah.
All right. Today we want to go into a little bit of parenting. Okay, so we are going to be sharing together on parenting. And like I usually say, if you have any question or any contribution, please don't hesitate. Just drop it on the comment section. We'll look at it and talk about it by the special grace of God. What your contributions are doing for us is great. It's awesome. We're learning. No man is an island. So, I want to look at parenting. Just tips about parenting. Okay. And I think parenting is only for a man and a woman. Or both of them?
Both of us.
Oh, both. All right.
Because we both produce them.
Oh.
It's not only for
us. All right. So maybe we'll do little today.
By the grace
just
of God.
Pick it up from there.
Okay. Yes. By the grace of God, we want to talk about parenting. How can we be a good parent?
Raising up our kids.
Our kids. And we have categories. We can introduce the categories today.
Okay.
We have 4 categories.
Yeah.
We have the babies.
Babies.
Babies between 0 months to 2 years.
Okay.
And we have childhood. Childhood is between 3 to 12 years. And we have teenhood or young adults, which is between 13 18 to 19. Okay, and we have after that.
People,
yeah, in fact, wonderful people, wonderful. We are one powerful principality. Praise God. And we have beyond 20 and above. So we're going to be taking just two today: parenting our babies and parenting our children.
Okay, now there are several aspects of parenting, but I think one that we're going to be looking at today, by the mercy of God, is love language, okay, our relationship
with our children.
Okay, our relationship is very important.
Exactly.
Don't forget, the first thing that I usually say is that children are the blessings of God. Okay, God gave us these children and He wants us, you know, to take care of them.
That's
right. We are stewards. That's the truth. We are stewards.
We are going to give
children. We are going to give account
of how we raise them.
We raise them and whatever we do with them. God loved children. Jesus demonstrated that when children came to Him, and the disciples were, go, this is a serious matter, this is a serious business. But Jesus said, no, suffer the little children to come, okay, because theirs is the kingdom of God, alright, and their angel always are before God, always before God.
Beholding the face of God.
Yeah, so children are very important.
The angels, wow.
They are rewards. Okay. That's another thing you need to know. Children are rewards to us as parents. God rewards us, maybe in our service, in our steward, in the house of God, in our steward to our relationship with God. God rewards us with children. So children are rewards. They are blessings from God. At the same time, they are rewards. Okay, so it's important that we lay that solid foundation so that we will know how to take care
of them.
God expects us to train them, actually. That's the word that God uses. Train up a child in the way that it should go. When it's old, it will not depart from it. The word training means that it's like somebody go for apprenticeship. Or somebody in school, you understand? In school, I study chemical engineering, she studied music, all right? So that is training. When they ask you what is your training, they are simply saying what is your profession, okay? And we go to school to learn this, they train us, okay? So it's important that parents understand that we are to train up our child. We are to train up our children. It's very important. Training involves you, okay? You don't allow
assign
children,
it to somebody else.
You can't assign, and you can't leave it to them that they will grow, okay? Yes, they will grow, but they may not be trained, okay? Training is deliberate.
Thank you. That's the word
I want to say.
I caught that.
Okay,
deliberate
is a deliberate attempt.
It's intentional.
Okay, training involves you being intentional with your kids, okay? I read in the scripture, when God was giving account, was giving testimony about Abraham, He said, I know him, that he's going to train, okay? He's going to command, in other words, he's going to train up his children in the word of God. And you see, there was a situation there that Abraham, indeed, the Bible says he had about 318 servants in his house, and he trained them. Okay?
He's a great man.
He trained 318 servants, and they won a war. They were not warriors. They were not soldiers. That's what training can do, okay? That's what training can do. When you train a child, they will bring reward back to you later in life. Training is key. So, you can't do it half-heartedly. You cannot just allow your children to just
go anyhow.
Okay, that's why we always pray for parents that you see, your family will not collapse in the
middle. Amen.
Because you can't compare children that grew up with
good parents
with children that grew up with
just single moms.
Like my parents used to say, you see, the growth will be like this.
Tilt towards one side. Or this way.
Yeah. If it's towards the
dad,
the mom, it will go like this. towards the dance.
It will not like it.
So it's important that we understand that we need to train. Bless you,
thank
sir.
You.
Thank
so,
you.
Good to see you again.
Thank you, thank you, thank you for giving us the support. God bless you. So training is key. It's an intentional
it's
thing.
It's intentional.
Okay, when God gives us kids, He entrusted in our hands that we'll be able to train
that's
them.
That's very true. Very true.
So we want to look into just the babies and then
and the childhood.
Childhood. How do we relate to
exactly.
that? How do we relate to them? You know, I know of couples that once their wife deliver a baby like this, they will go and rest. Okay? They will just go and rest. It's my wife's business. Is it supposed to be like
it's
that?
It's not supposed
okay.
to be like that.
It's not supposed to be.
It's not supposed to be. A child in life, any child growing, needs the father's instruction and the mom's instruction.
Yeah.
They need you around. They need you as a father. They need you as a mom. Not only mommy's business.
Mm.
Because I was the one that carried for 9 months.
Yeah.
Then my father, my husband has finished his job. No.
Mm.
In fact, the day the baby came, the two of you are just bigger. Another phase of your life.
Yeah. You don't change room.
No, you no.
And you said okay, my wife doesn't give up. Just
so
give
I don't
her
want
her
the one. I just
okay,
give her.
Let, me just
let her be taking care of
me. Because that's
his
have to.
Personal
come to think about it. Come to think about it. Come, we are talking about babies now. Babies. What about like me now? My schedule is very tight. Most of the time, I don't sleep in the night. All right. So how do you want me to cope? And this time. The baby, you know babies now, they wake up in the night.
The Bible says wisdom is profitable to guide in all things.
Okay.
Wisdom.
How?
Wisdom is profitable to guide in all
okay, what she's saying is this, okay? Commitment is mentor. Right?
It may not be more than 30 minutes.
Yes, you have to show commitment.
Just show commitment. I'm not the only one. I didn't invent it myself. You found time. To do that,
that's right.
Then you shouldn't leave. You shouldn't leave.
Oh, no, it's true. You find time to impregnate your wife, so you should find time to
be committed to
raising
the product of the two of you.
So don't do the work in the middle of the night, and at the same time, when the work now finally shows up, you are
now
taking the back
that. Door.
No, don't be too busy.
No,
man, you have to be a part of it. See what my wife is saying. You have to be part of raising up our kids now. What are the relationships that is expected when we have a new baby in our hands?
Okay, number one thing that the baby wants, the love language of a baby is love touch. If you notice
touch.
Most of our babies, they just want to be in the comfort of the morning.
Yeah.
They just want to be somebody who wants to also. Don't forget the fact that when they are coming from is very cozy. So they want a dark, cozy environment. That's why until they touch you, until they cling to you, until they come close, or you carry them, or you bag them like our mothers do, you know, most of the time you want your baby to sleep fast, supposed to just put them at your back. You discover that in just less than 5-10 minutes, the baby will sleep off. What are they looking for? Love touch.
Love touch.
They just
love
want
touch.
To be touched with love. Once you throw your baby at the back, you can do million things. It can be there for 3-4 hours because he knows that I am in comfort of a warm or somebody's environment. I am not left alone.
That's right.
Put that baby inside the court, remove the baby and put the baby in the in less than 30 minutes, you will hear the cry. Because he knows that I am not touching anybody. Love touch.
Okay,
their
love
touch. Language is love touch.
The love
majorly.
Language of babies.
Yes.
Between 0 and 2 is love touch.
Love touch,
okay, so,
majorly.
So, husband and wife need to understand this, alright? And in bringing them up, in training them, we need to show that we care.
Mm.
We need to show that we love them.
Affection.
Okay? They don't just drop them
anyhow
in one place. Okay? I know that 21st century
moms, parents,
we are busy people. We are
moving.
Okay? Even what we are talking about is if you have a baby between
zero and two years.
Okay, great time. As a father,
we did say you should not walk.
Yeah, you come back from work, carry him, throw him off, you know, play with him. Babies want love touch. Okay, as a father, okay, you have been working since morning and you came back home tired, still create time, 1 hour, 1.5 hours. You see, the most amazing time is for me to get back home. My wife knows this. Once I enter my house, I don't want to go out. That's the kind of person I am. Okay. I may delay outside, I may come home late, there's nothing wrong with that. But once I step into my house, it will take a lot of effort for me to come out again.
Yes.
Because I want to play with my kids. Okay? I want to play. I want to be with them. I want to be with my family. Alright? So create time. Create time for your children. Create time for that baby. You understand? When you come back home, give him a love touch. Okay? Give her a love touch. Oh, how are you today? God bless you from me. I was great. I was your great, even though they don't have.
They can hear you. You might feel that those between that age, even if they're not responding back to you, don't make a mistake. She can't hear me and you are not talking. Please, you are not helping the group.
What of somebody that doesn't like all this? Baby, I carry baby. He poo or he really he all this on my body.
Once you are a parent, no matter how neat freak you are, a baby will wee or poo on you. He's your child. Then there's no reason for that anymore now, because most of the time they are on their diapers. So you can carry your baby with that, and what is even wrong with you?
Alright, so love touch is number one language for babies. Please get that. What's another thing?
Okay, the second one, are we moving on from baby?
Yes, no, let's take baby.
Another one for baby is giving gifts. What do I mean? I'm not sure. If you definitely between 0 and 2 years, they don't know whether you bought shoe or you bought bag or you bought diaper. What I'm talking about, feeding them.
Yeah.
You discover. I just want to use this scenario. You discover that some parents, when they leave their child with their house girls or their nanny, you discover that the nanny, the baby is tending towards the nanny more than the mate, more than their mom.
Because they're the one that is feeding them.
Why? The reason is that they see that face regularly putting something in their mouth, taking care of them, cleaning the face, cleaning their faces, their body, their bum, and everything. They can see. They can touch her, they always see her.
So
smiling.
The gift, what you're saying now is that
giving gifts.
The gift of baby
feeding them. That's the only thing they recognize that time. If you buy the shoe of 10 million naira. They will not know whether it's 10 million or not. But
so,
putting cereal, putting milk, putting that Ribena in their mouth with one hand, they see that hand regularly. Oh my God. If the kids not taking that baby, we forget the parents and test what they mean.
So what we are saying is this, as a father, you need to take time to feed your baby. See, number one, we said, touch them, carry them.
With affection.
Those are love language of babies.
Exactly.
Between 0 and 2 years. That's why you see that when you go and drop them in school or in church, you see, they don't want to leave you. God bless you, sister.
Thank you. God bless you.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
You see, when you go and drop them, you see baby crying.
Yes.
They don't want to leave you. Okay? They don't want to leave that home for that love. You understand? So as a father and as a mother, number one thing that you do for your baby is that touch them,
love touch,
carry them.
Affection.
That love touch, that's their language.
Mm.
Love touch. That tells them that you love them.
You belong
them.
Here.
Okay,
you are accepted.
Here. Carry them in your chest as a man. Carry that baby.
I've even
chest.
Seen men
and,
using carrier and carry their babies around.
Let it feel your heartbeat. Let her feel your. I love when my babies were very young. I love carrying them to my chest. Okay, you put them in your chest. That shows, you understand. That shows love. That shows care.
Affection.
I will say secondly, okay, this is not only to women. Please, men.
You have to wake up.
You have to, because training is key. We are still coming to training. We are just talking about.
Parenting is intentional.
Yes. This one is just, we are just talking about their love language. We'll give you 2 for now. Okay, if you need more, then you can contact us for that. Now, the second point of love language to babies is
giving gifts.
Giving gifts. And what's the gift?
Feed them.
Feeding them.
Feeding them.
That's it. When they see you, that your hand
is always, towards them, giving them, making them smile. When you put a food in their mouth, you see smile.
Yeah.
Oh, you see amazing smile that you cannot, you can't reject.
So as a man, you carry that feeding bottle, put it in his mouth or her mouth, carry that spoon and feed your baby. It's important. By the time he matches your face with the gift,
Oh my God, that settles it for them.
Oh my God, that settles it. So, those two is what we are going to give you. Let's take the
childhood.
Okay, there's a difference between babies
and being a child.
Let's check.
The age between is between 3 to 12.
Those are children.
These ones, their major language, number one, their first language also is love. They want to touch. Those are the age, this is the age that they will see them run. When the mommy, hello, back down, they hear the horn of their daddy.
They run towards
you. Cannot tie them down. That's immediately right. They watch out and they run.
Mobile.
Oh my God. And hold, if I jump sometimes, especially boys and girls that are very agile, you see them jump up on top of their parents and like, you'll be wondering, where did you get this energy from? Yeah. They're always jumping.
So touching.
Love touch. Basically, number
is
one.
Number two
is that they want to play. Allow them to play. They are children. I remember sometimes ago, maybe like last year, I was talking to them. Don't cage them. Don't let them behave like you. They are not you.
That's awesome. You know what? Children can never be adults.
Can never. Except you want to perform a miracle.
Okay? At that age, they are not adults. So you can't make them to behave like you. You can't make them to think like you. You can't make them to act like you. And what does children do? They love playing. So you allow them to play. They love playing, allow them to play. That does not mean you leave them to go haywire. You have to control it.
Yes.
You control their play.
Exactly.
You monitor them. And that's where training comes in. Okay? Most of these footballers that we see, their parents noticed this talent early in life while they were playing. Okay, so you allow them
to be themselves. Yeah. Allow them to be themselves.
You will notice the ingenuity of a child when he's playing.
Their best comes out.
Comes out when they are playing.
Exactly. Okay. Let them be
you know
themselves.
The one that is a brain. When they are playing.
Exactly.
You know the one that is the mouth when they are playing. Okay, so
you're not the one that is hand.
The hand.
We have brain, we have mouth, we have hand expression. All of this can only be discovered when they are playing.
When they are playing.
You study them when they are doing that. The one that talks more about it to you all the time, you know that definitely is tending to what a communicator.
Yeah.
Or what do you call this motivational speaker?
Yeah.
Are you getting what I'm saying? Yeah. You begin to speak it into his life right there.
Yeah.
The one we play, you see with book and quiet. Even in the play, you see him us with something.
Yeah.
Meditating.
Their tendency
begin to come out
when they are playing. So don't block children from playing.
Eh?
We are not saying that they should not be playing all through the day, 24 hours. No, that's not what we are talking about. But allow them to play because that is
their
level. That is where they are at that particular
time. Their children.
Between the ages
of 3 to 12
is they love to play. So you must create time for them to play. If they attend any school that they don't have playground, withdraw them. They must have playground.
That's true.
You see? You don't lock them inside and say, man, pick your boot, go and do this. There is time for that. For them to read, for them to do
exactly.
And the house.
Yes, house chores.
Yes,
it's part of it.
It's part of it.
It's part of training,
but majorly,
intentionally.
Majorly. You discover the talent, you discover the best, you discover the gift in a child between 3 and 12 while they are playing. Very important. Is that not so? You discover it and their best come out at that particular time. So you allow them to play, but you monitor them.
That's where intentional training.
Okay, so when we're talking about intentional in our training of children, now apart from playing, okay, what do you think we can put in place, especially for childhood between 3 and and then 12 talk about.
Okay, at that age, what I do most of the time for my children is that you do intellectual play games with them. What are the intellectual games? Some of them have it in school, some of them have it on phone. You know, you give them puzzles to solve. Okay, you give them solve puzzles. That, by the grace of God, you throw questions at them. Don't leave spirituality out also. Give them memory verses. Let them recite back to you in 2 hours. Are you getting what I'm saying? That means you're taxing their brain to work extra.
Yeah.
Are you getting what I'm saying? That's part of the intentional training that we're talking about. Not only that, you know, just leave them, they don't have any spirituality at all. There was a time I was talking to one of my friends, a pastor. I just threw something about on the wife and the children. I discovered they do not have any spirituality. I said, sir, this is a shame to you. As a father, you're a pastor, and your children cannot come out with something. And your wife. That means being the fact that the wife is the only one training the children. So because she does business, she's not spiritual yet. She's not that spiritual
strong,
yet.
Yeah.
Exactly. She's not that strong yet. The same thing goes to the children. They're just there.
So you don't leave the training of your children.
So your wife alone.
Your wife alone. Be intentional.
The two of you get involved intentionally.
Be intentional. By the grace of God, as we are online now, life, my children are behind the scenes working. Okay.
Working endlessly.
They are the one with all everything. What do I mean about all this guidance? But they are doing it. Okay? So be intentional about training. Don't leave your children to only your wife or to only your husband. Be cooperative. The two of you must be part of it.
And another warning I want to send this morning, don't leave your children to TV to train. Don't let the society, the environment, or television, don't allow it to be the major trainer for your children.
Most of the time today, children of nowadays, they are being trained
by
either
TV,
by TV or by household or by society.
It's dangerous.
The father has gone to work, the wife has gone to work,
and the maid does not want problems with TV.
The maid doesn't want to just put them on TV. They watch cartoon. All these things need to be monitored.
Regulated.
All these things
regulated.
Need to be regulated. Be intentional. That's the word. Be intentional about it. Like my wife said, you have to train your kids spiritually. If you're a Christian, you need to train them spiritually. How do you train them spiritually? Give them memory verses, okay? Give them Bible peace.
Exactly.
Okay. Things that will commit them. Is that not
true? Yes.
So it's important that we are committed to this. Train up a child in the way that
And the best training you can ever give your children is for you to do it and let them see it.
Thank you. You are talking. Maybe you should explain that.
Okay, by the grace of God, I want my children to pray. It's not you can't be an hypocrite when you are training your children. Because these children, they know how to find out. They will find out who truly you are. So you cannot hide who you are. Are you getting what I'm saying? If you are not praying and you tell them to pray, they will do it in your presence. Once you stand up and you leave, they'll go back to who they are.
That's right.
So let them see you
doing it.
Train them with your lifestyle. Mm. Let them know that mommy is praying and nobody should disturb. And they definitely, if you now want to discipline that, have you read your Bible? They will know that mommy is asking me to read my Bible as a child.
She has done her own.
She's asking me to go and pray. She has prayed this morning.
Hallelujah.
Not that you are doing something that you are not doing by yourself. You are telling them to do something that you are not doing. It will not
last.
They
will see it as discipline.
Your life is transparent. Them. They will see it.
Mm.
And you are sending bad signal into them. And they will never listen to you later in life if you do not start from there. So start from there. Let them see you do what you are telling them to do. Let them see your life
be a leader,
be a mentor.
Yes, leadership is by example.
Mm.
Okay, that's all. Leadership is by example. There was a story of a young boy that I learned that the father said, "Sit down, Junior." And Junior said, "Dad, I don't want to sit down." The dad said, "I said, Junior, sit down." He said, "Dad, I don't want to sit down." By the time the dad now changed his face, brought out
the belt,
came and said, "Junior, I said, sit down. You know what the guy
sat down,
he said, "Okay, no problem." He sat down and he was
shaking probably.
So the dad said, "What's that?
What's wrong with you?"
He said, "Well, I am sitting down on the outside,
but
so inside me, I'm standing up." So which means that child wants to see you do what you are telling him to do. Alright? Example is the best, it's everything. When you want to train your child, be the example. Be an example of what you are preaching. Be a good example of what you are preaching. Be a good example. Okay? You don't do it, then they will hear you. Okay? So parents, we have a lot in our hands. I believe God that we are going to be looking into the difference between discipline and we are going to be looking at the difference between discipline and punishment by the grace of God
tomorrow
concerning our child, because we are moving to
teenhood
and the adulthood by the special grace of God. We are taking babies today
and
childhood. Okay.
So by the grace of God tomorrow, we're going to be talking about teenagers.
Yes.
And then above 20.
Yeah, so how do we
relate with
them? How do we relate with them? How do we communicate with them? How do we get across to them without losing them?
Mm.
It's important. You know, it's possible your child will be living with you, but
and you don't know anything.
You don't know anything.
I
heard about that story of
the
one that got pregnant
under the nose. And
parents
do not know.
And the parents do not know that she was pregnant.
Well, over 6 months.
I think it was about 3 months before they discovered that, she was pregnant. 3 months.
I've heard of 6 months.
Nobody knew. And he was staying in the same house. You understand? So it's possible for you to lose touch with your child if care is not taken. So we're going to be looking at that. You know, we're talking about training. So we are looking at punishment.
The difference between punishment and discipline.
Because that's part of training.
Yes.
There is no training in life without
discipline.
There is no training in life without
punishment.
Alright, so
once in a while it's expected.
Yeah, so we are going to be looking into that, because as we are going in, there is a level of discipline or punishment for childhood. Even for babies. I understand that you can discipline
exactly
a baby. Okay, I've seen that with my wife. You know, she run a crèche, and you see babies. I'll be moved. Why don't you answer this baby? He said, no. I'm training. If I continue like this, then this baby will not know what I'm trying to teach him or her. So we are going to be looking at that tomorrow by the grace of God. Well done today. You did well. Glory to God in the highest. I hope this blessed you today. The Lord bless and keep you in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for your home. We pray for your children. Many of you that have babies and you have child, you have children, I decree the hand of God will come upon them in Jesus' name. I command supernatural wisdom for you. to train up your children in the name of Jesus. You will not lose any of them. You will not bury any of them. In the name of Jesus. And as many of you that are trusting God for the fruit of the womb, your womb is open now.
Amen.
Receive your babies now. Receive your babies now. In the name of Jesus. Many of you that want to get married, I decree favor for you.
Amen.
It shall be well with you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Please don't forget to share this video to be a blessing to many. In case you need more consultation, we are available. You can just send us email or just send a message or a comment in the comment section that will be there to render the assistance. You can consult or you can ask any questions. They will be there to render that help to you. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. If you watch this program, you are not born again. That's why we're here. I want to pray with you. We want to pray with you. Put your right hand on your chest as we pray together. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you today as a sinner. Forgive me my sins. Jesus, come into my heart. Come into my life. I receive you as my Lord and as my Savior. From today, I am born again. Satan, I reject you. I belong to Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for receiving me. In Jesus' name. Amen. Congratulations. If you pray that prayer, you are born again.
Welcome to the body of Christ.
Welcome to the body of Christ. Your faith may not change, but something has changed inside of you. So join a Bible believing church that is very close to your house. I'm sure there is a Bible believing church close to your house. In case you are in Lagos, Nigeria, close to Ogba, then you can fellowship with us. Splendor Church International, number 43 College Road in Ogba, Ikeja. We will be glad to be your pastor in the name of Jesus. The Lord bless you. Relationship is everything in life. That's what we preach. That's our gospel.
That's
what we believe in. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. Until we see you again, same time tomorrow.
Grace and mercy of God.
By the grace and the mercy of God, 1 o'clock, GMT plus 1. Don't forget this, that you are gloriously blessed. God bless you.
You.
We see you tomorrow. God's willing, by the
grace. God bless you.